Good morning, students. How are you? I feel that all are well. Dear students, once time again, I am in front of you. I am going to teach civics chapter number 1, the role of constitution. Dear students, in first class I have denoted that there are 3 branches of social study: history, geography and civics. So I have denoted the father of civics is Aristotle, yani you can say Arastu. Understand? Aristotle is known as the father of civics or pol science, yani political science. Dear students, we will discuss in about that role of constitution. You know very well that constitution is a main role of every country. If those country have no constitution, that country is not going very well. That's why we know very well that we were slavery of the Britisher. Britisher ruled all over India within 200 years. So we were slaver of the Britisher. So dear students, when India became freedom on 15th August 1947, we know very well this day will celebrate as Independence Day in India. On the occasion of Independence Day, the Prime Minister of India hoists the national flag on the Red Fort. But on that day, there was no constitution that our country was not a sovereign country. So dear students, I am discussing in about that the role of constitution. Constitution, it is a set of written or unwritten rules and guidelines that help in governing the country. Yani like this, samvidhan ek aisa niyam pranali ki ek books hoti hai jise koi bhi desh sanchalit hota hai, chalta hai. Understand? Constitution is a set of written or unwritten rules and guidelines that help in the governing the country. It includes the fundamental rights. Not include a fundamental rights. It denotes the duties of the citizens of every country. That's there are many fundamental rights and there are many duties of the citizens of every country, and every country have their constitution. Now it includes not only rights of the people but also their duties. Also it denotes the duties. What is the duty of yours for the favor of our country? Hamari kuch duty hai. Suppose that railway platform pe aap khade hain aur koi jo hai railway संसाधन को यानी रेलवे रिसोर्सेज को डिस्ट्रॉय कर रहा हो, नुकसान पहुंचा रहा हो, तो आपकी ड्यूटी बनती है कि वो आप उसे रोकें, आप पुलिस को सूचना दें, पुलिस को इन्फॉर्म करें कि दिस बॉय इज दिस पर्सन इज डिस्ट्रॉइंग द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द रेलवे. सो दैट्स दिस इज ड्यूटीज. सो नाउ नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस. सो आई एम डिस्कसिंग इन अबाउट दैट्स ओनली कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस. Making of Indian Constitution, it was 1934. INC इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस कमेटी, इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस कमेटी, द डिमांड फॉर ए कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन असेंबली वॉज मेड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम बाई इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस, भारतीय कांग्रेस, भारतीय कांग्रेस की स्थापना, इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश, INC वॉज एस्टैब्लिश इन 1885. So that this organization, Indian National Congress, has demanded for the Constituent Assembly, and in 1940 accepted by the British government, whenever peoples and leaders, some important leaders who is the favor of the country are working in India, so that they have demanded a Constituent Assembly. So that's why the British government has decided and accepted in 1940 the Constituent Assembly, and in 1946 election were held for Constituent Assembly. It was an election for Constituent Assembly, and Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who was the first president of India, who was appointed as the chairman of the Constituent Assembly. And in 1946, it was a election of Constituent Assembly, so that Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, you can say, was the Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar became the first chairman of this assembly. So he is also known as the father of constitution. Understand? Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar was known as the father of constitution. And in 1947, this became the Constituent Assembly for Free India in 1947. Yes, dear students, this is the question of this, when India became independent. India became independent on 15th August 1947, and the Constituent Assembly was doing the work. They have taken some rules and guidelines from every country of the constitutions of the every country. They have taken from USA, they have taken from Spain, they have taken from Holland, many types of rules and guidelines. These are converted in the Indian constitution. Indian constitution is the big constitution of the world. You can say Indian constitution is the written constitution who is very big of the world constitution. Understand? Now I am coming, that's 29 August 1947, drafting committee appointed for drafting the constitution, and constitution was completed on 17th October 1949. Yani like this you can say, it was completed on 17th October 1949. It was very ready. It was prepared for this. Then you can say on 17th October 1949, it was ready. On 26th November 1949, it was adopted by the Constituent Assembly. But question is this. You can say, sir, why have not came in force on 26 November 1949? Because it was adopted by the Constituent Assembly. So, dear students, I am giving answer of these questions. Once time, the first Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, was delivering the speech on Lahore Adhivation. On that day was 26 Jan, and that day Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru demanded Purna Swaraj. That day was 26 Jan, so that I said 26 November 1949, it was adopted by the Constituent Assembly, but it was not, did not come in force 26 November, because our leader was thinking about the dispatch of the Prime Minister of India, who had delivered the speech on the Lahore Adhivation. So our important leaders decided we will this constitution bring on force 26 Jan 1950. So that's why it came in force 26 Jan 1950, and on the occasion of this, the President of India hoists the national flag on the Red Fort, and on that day was very important because it came into the force, and it is known as in Indian history a Republic Day of India. On the occasion of this, the President of India, Dr. Rajinder Prasad, hoists the national flag on the Red Fort. So you can say that day was very, very important in Indian history. And constitution, whenever we have no constitution, so India was not a sovereign country. And whenever we have completed the constitution and it came in the force on 26 Jan 1950, so India became a sovereign country. Yani like this, bachon, Bharat ek samvaidhanik samprabhutva वाला देश है, यानी इंडिया इज ए सोवर्जिन कंट्री. सो इट हैज ऑन रूल्स एंड गाइडलाइंस इन लाइक दिस, इट हैज ऑन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन दैट यू कैन से इंडिया इज ए सोवर्जिन कंट्री. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप दैट मे बी चांसेस इफ somebody इज आस्किंग टू यू दैट how can you say constitution came in force on this day, so you can say constitution came in constitutions came in the force on 26 Jan 1950. okay, so dear students, hamara apna samvidhan bana, aur ye samvidhan 26 जनवरी 1950 ईस्वी को पूरे देश में लागू किया गया, रेगुलाइज कर दिया गया. और तभी से हम 15 अगस्त 1947 को जो हमारा देश आज़ाद हुआ था, 15 अगस्त को हम द इंडिपेंडेंस डे के नाम से जानते हैं, और 26 जैन को रिपब्लिक डे के नाम से जानते हैं. यानी 26 जैन इट इज़ ऑल्सो नॉन एज रिपब्लिक डे, 15th August it is also known as the Independence Day, and 2 October Gandhi Jayanti. These are three important national holidays. These are three important national holidays. So on this day are very, very important in Indian history. So bachon, आज के लिए बस इतना ही. मिलते हैं एक लंबे ब्रेक के बाद नेक्स्ट वीडियो में. थैंक यू सो मच.